is formwork release agent. So now, in the case of self-compacting concrete, this is also very, very important, formwork releasing agent. Because normally we have the aluminium shuttering or we have the plastic shuttering. So what type of formwork releasing agent you have to apply? That is very, very important. You know what is the formwork releasing agent? Shuttering oil. What you say, shuttering oil. This is a shuttering oil. So normally shuttering oil, whatever you are putting on the ply or in the steel, that will not work for if you are using for aluminium shuttering and plastic shuttering. Self-compacting concrete normally produces a very high quality finish, giving a mirror copy of the formwork. So if you see the construction of the self-compacting concrete, so even you can see your face on the surface, concrete surface. And I tell you that why this construction practices has widely accepted, because the quality of the finish. And because of the improved quality of the finish, even you don't require the plaster and all, so the speed of the construction is very, very high. Okay? So it is a mirror image you are getting of the concrete. So in the formwork, if any dust is there, then dust appearance will get there. Suppose if you are applying the shuttering oil somewhere thin, somewhere thick, that appearance will come to your concrete finish. So that's why high quality finish you can get. Excess releasing agent at the form phase and concrete interface can result extending extension of air bubbles and other imperfections. Now you see, I'm telling you very, very important aspects here. What happens if you do the self-compacting concrete? Normally you see the concrete surface. Normally you will see on the concrete surface the air voids are there, air bubbles are there. Why it is there? Because aluminium shuttering, whatever it is, or you are using the plastic shuttering, they are totally impermeable. They don't allow the air to travel out. So what happened when you put the concrete, the air is trapped, and that air you can see on the surface of the concrete. So that's why you have to apply very thin so that air could not trap and can escape easily from the surface. So what is the material you use? You can use vegetable, mineral, or water-based mold releasing agent. Need to be applied extremely thin, almost to the point that they are just wiped on with a cloth, or sometimes we use bent roller. So they are using the roller now. Sometimes we apply that roller to apply.
Excuse me, sir. Sir, yes. PPT is not visible actually.
Sir, you can just pen through Society for Civil and Environmental Engineers presentation.
Once again, Abhishek, you announce everything.
It's okay. Fine. You can just pin to Society for Civil and Environmental Engineers presentation.
Thank you. Thank you. I will mind.
And sir, the voice is little bit interrupted in this other link. So you can just keep the mic near to your mouth.
Surely.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah. Yes, you can continue.
Okay. So next is the self-compacting concrete will normally allow entrapped air to escape between the concrete and the formwork. Consequently, the release agent must also be of type which will allow air to migrate in a controlled manner and escape from the concrete. So, certain releasing agents which used in combination with the impermeable formwork are too viscous to allow air to escape effectively, and this can result in the air void adhering to the surface of the formwork, resulting in the hole in the concrete. Now you see this type of impression you will see on the concrete surface. This, there are two reasons for this. I tell you, there are two reasons for this. First is that the air is entrapped. And one thing you will notice in the case of nylon shuttering, aluminium shuttering, or you say that plastic shuttering, where you have the box type of shuttering system, okay, composite shuttering system. If some error is appearing at one place, if you will not correct that error, it will repeat at the same place at other locations also. Okay? So, best way is to, there are two reasons. First is that either you have put the thin, thick, your mold releasing agent, or your mold releasing agent is not okay, or your distance for the level of concrete is very high, so that in between the water is, sorry, air is trapped. But another reason is that your the admixtures, whatever you are using, they are having very high percentage of air content. I know some of the persons from the chemical industry is also there. They may refer to me, but I tell you, this is also the reason that if, because in the PC-based admixture to have a very smooth concrete, they put some, they put some air. Sometimes PC is also having quality of taking some air. There are the basically two reasons. First reason is very important. Second reason, normally the that is also there. So what is the takeaway from this? How to apply the releasing agent? The releasing agent must be applied thin and uniform. On surfacing, after cleaning the surface, you have to apply. After cleaning the surface, if you are moving any strain on your surfacing surface, that will reflect back to your carpet finished surface. So you have to clean it properly. Quality of surfacing oil must be properly selected.